the A320 would indeed be the worthy successor to its precursors, inheriting innovations that would allow the creation of a totally new aircraft, composite materials for the structure, a fully digital cockpit with electric flight controls and the famous fly-by-wire, making way for the two-man flight deck. Yet another argument to get the airline's mouths watering. Yes, our prodigy was certainly the worthy heir to its predecessors. In the four corners of Europe, the A320 was starting to take shape. When it was finally put together, 3 years after the program was launched, it was at last officially presented. The perfect prodigy was to be the first Airbus to benefit from an exceptional unveiling ceremony. The first public appearance was made alongside a royal couple, no less. This auspicious occasion foresaw an exceptional future for the aircraft, as if people had an idea of just how much a success it would be for Airbus. On the 22nd of February 1987, it was much more than an aircraft that was about to take off to meet its destiny. A week after the presentation that had attracted everyone's attention, the A320 took off from Blagnac Airport runway. The grey sky was in stark contrast with the enthusiasm this maiden flight aroused among the flight test crews.
Le vol s'est très bien passé et je dois dire que notre première pensée va essentiellement aux gens qui pendant de longues années se sont crevé la peau pour arriver à faire un avion aussi réussi.
Even as the maiden flight was coming to an end, the A320 was already a reality for many airlines who were completely won over by the aircraft, which was already promising to be one of Airbus's great sales performances. There were nearly 400 aircraft on order for about 15 airlines all over the world, including Northern Airlines, one of the United States' most emblematic carriers. Never before in the history of aviation had a European plane met with such enthusiasm before its maiden flight. The orders kept on growing throughout the certification period that ended in February 1988. During this period, the aircraft benefited from telemetry for the first time. This innovation considerably reduced development and certification times, and above all, put the A320 through tests that would prove it was one of the safest and best performing aircraft.
En 12 mois, nous avons fait plus de 1500 heures de vol d'essai à une cadence de l'ordre de 60 heures par mois et par avion. Dans tous les cas, la 320 n'a pas péché par un manque de fiabilité pendant la phase la plus critique qui était sa phase de développement.